أول.
ماشي.
إيه ولد؟ أنا.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great honor that I humbly stand before you on behalf of all my colleagues, the distinguished African ambassadors, accredited to the Royal Kingdom of the Netherlands on this special and memorable Africa Day. I am indeed overwhelmed by the wonderful attires you have adorned on this occasion, which is a true reflection of our vibrant and diverse cultures which are present here today. Before I proceed with my brief remarks, I would like to implore all of you to take a moment and to look back to the year 1963, when our forefathers in the African continent established the Organization of African Unity, or AU, on May 25th of that year. The early 1960s was a historic period in the African continent that saw young, energetic, and charismatic Pan-African leaders that were passionate for the prosperity of its people. It was a time that was characterized by a "we can do it" attitude. The period was dominated by the need for political and economic freedoms. The political messages vibrating then in the continent were inspirational and unifying for one cause and goal: for socio-economic prosperity, especially achieving sustainable development by engaging the youth in economic activities. I believe that it is their powerful young energy that still remains untapped and put to optimal use by the African continent almost 50 years ago, when the African leaders spoke in one unequivocal voice. It is incumbent upon all of us as leaders, stakeholders, and cherished friends of Africa to seriously consider harnessing the economic potential of the youth so that they can substantially contribute to the rapid economic development of the African continent. Distinguished guests, this day calls on all of us to take stock of the successes we have achieved so far as a continent, as well as the challenges ahead that we have to confront and overcome. From east to west and north to south, every inch of the African continent is free from colonial domination. Within the continent, there are successful regional groupings. To mention just a few, we have the East African Community, EAC, the Common Market for Eastern and Southern Africa, COMESA, Economic Community for West Africa States, ECOWAS, and the Maghreb Community of States. The main objective of these regional groupings is to build a united capacity for the African continent in order to effectively participate in the world trade and development. Ladies and gentlemen, in the vanguard of the economic development of the continent is the youth. It constitutes 62% of Africa's overall population that fall below the age of 35. More than half of them survive on less than $2 a day. 6,000 young people are infected with HIV/AIDS every day all over the world. Most of them are girls in sub-Saharan Africa. Unfortunately, these are the realities of our young people we have to confront as a challenge. The gap between the Millennium Development Goals, targets, and its interconnection to the current state of our young people leaves no time for questions. Lost opportunities for the youth are missed opportunities for future generations, and which are also costly to reverse, both for the young and for the entire society. Ladies and gentlemen, across our vast continent, there are several commitments, policies, projects, and programs on youth that have been prioritized by our leaders at the national and sub-regional levels. Though we all acknowledge that there is much to be accomplished within these initiatives. However, it is through concerted and innovative efforts that we will continue to accelerate the youth empowerment for sustainable development. Ladies and gentlemen, the large cohort of young people presents great opportunities for development if appropriate investments in human capital are made to equip the youth with the requisite skills in the areas of information, science, technology, and agriculture, among others, for gainful employment. Educational programs should provide the youth with skills to compete favorably in the emerging regional markets, the global market, as well as to cater for their livelihoods. Accelerating youth empowerment for sustainable development, as this day's theme is, and leadership is achieved through increasing its importance in the development agenda of national governments, in regional entities, and in international development organizations. That includes the continent's concrete efforts to build youth capacities for quality and meaningful participation in development and decision-making processes. Most notably, there is a new and strong momentum in our various countries to promote the participation of youths in a wide range of policy dialogues and policy development initiatives in order to ensure that the youth perspectives are addressed in these processes and taken into account for implementation. The African Youth Forum that took place in April 2011 at the African Union headquarters in Addis Ababa provided the necessary platform for the youth to seriously dialogue and share their views on the youth empowerment agenda. The forum acknowledged the youth as critical actors and called for effective commitment and actions on the part of all stakeholders and partners at all levels to mainstream youth concerns into development policies, strategies, programs, and plans in Africa. The deliberations of this forum are going to be considered by the AU summit in their next meeting in July. Ladies and gentlemen, let us take this opportunity to acknowledge also and commend the United Nations General Assembly for making the year 2010 to 2011 as the International Year of the Youth. This is strategically in line with the United Nations Plan of Action, as well as the Millennium Development Goals, which we are all striving to accomplish by 2015. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and honor for me to call on our guest of honor, Mrs. Marjolaine Dion, Deputy Mayor of Den Haag, to officially open these celebrations. Thank you.